So good morning, good evening, and good afternoon to viewers from all walks of life. This is Denzomos, and I welcome you to the channel of truth, enlightenment, freedom, and the channel of breaking empaths free. For the ones who are just coming in and narcissism resonates with you, I invite you to join our tribe, like our page, share with your friends, subscribe. For those who have always been with me, welcome back, and I thank you for your continued love and support. Now, it took me a while before I decided to talk about this subject. It may have taken me almost a year before I decided to mention something about the twin flame. Now, I'm not a twin flame. That is not my area. But I'm going to give my input on the twin flames who are also narcissists in disguise. Now, people, there is three things that are going to happen as you wake up. If you have awakened from narcissistic abuse, there's three types of people you're most likely going to meet. If you have done the work to heal, if you have healed and you've become a healed empath, you are going to attract your soulmate. Why? Because you are in that vibrational match of somebody who is in your wavelength, which means you are a healed empath. Definitely, you're going to attract somebody who is also a healed empath, or most likely somebody in your same wavelength. Number two, you will attract your twin flame. Now, your twin flame is going to probably, very likely going to come in shortly after you awaken. It could take a couple of months, but it is not going to take long before actually you come face to face with your twin flame. Now, what I don't really know is whether every one of us will have the chance or opportunity to meet their twin flames. I don't know that. Like I've said, I'm not very much into the twin flame thing. It's not my field. But the third person you're likely going to attract is the narcissist, is the twin flame who is also the narcissist in disguise. In this video, we are going to focus deeply on the third one. The narcissist, what you need to understand, people, the narcissist, they are very good at mirroring their victims. So the very first thing the narcissist does when they meet you, most of the cases, they are going to mirror you. Each and everything you do, it is going to look like, actually, it's unbelievable and too good to be true, most of the cases. And like I said, for some of the people, actually, it may be hard for them to realize that actually they have met their twin flame. Some individuals will not actually notice this event. The twin flame connection, people, is a divine connection. The reason why twin flames are coming into your life, usually after the awakening, that is because one of the twin flames is also a narcissist and is also a very toxic individual. And most of the cases, the reason why they show up in your life sometimes after your awakening, that means that they are coming into your life so that you can help to wake them up. That is usually why the twin flames are coming in most of the time after your awakening. You are the one who is woke. You are awakened. So basically, you are ready to meet your twin flame, no matter what state they are. It does not matter whether they have awakened or not. Most of the cases, that's why you see in most of the comments, even sometime on my page, I've seen a lot of individuals, a lot of my subscribers who have talked about meeting their twin flames, who have actually appeared and happened to be toxic. The reason why your twin flame is coming in is because your twin flame is coming in also to receive their awakening. You have awakened, and the only thing remaining is meeting your twin flame, and you are the person responsible for awakening them. So most of the cases, that's why you see those twin flame relationships, they never end into something, they never end into a fruitful connection, because it is very likely that twin flame is not coming into your life to form some kind of a partnership with you. It is not an intimate connection. This is a divine connection, it's not an intimate connection. So it may be few cases whereby people have actually met their twin flames and have actually gotten into a full-blown relationship with them. It has happened as well, but most of the cases, it is very rare. It is a very, very rare incident that actually you can ever meet your twin flame and you guys will have a successful and fruitful relationship or even sometime a connection with them. So usually, some people misunderstand this thing to be some kind of a soulmate thing. So they misunderstand this thing to be a relationship or sometimes an intimate connection. That is why most of the cases, when the twin flames are coming in, most of the individuals have noticed that the twin flames, they have appeared and they have actually happened to be narcissists themselves. Sometimes even sociopaths or even sometimes psychopaths. The twin flame will come into your life. Why? Because the basic reason they are coming and showing up in your life all of a sudden, that is because they are coming in to get awakened. So most of the cases, they're going to pick up on your energy, and you are the person responsible for awakening them. How do you awaken them? By enlightening them, by showing them their direction in life. And actually, most of the twin flame connections, they are coming in because they have got to get awakened, so that they can actually finally eventually step into their purpose as well. Because you, as an individual, you have awakened. So it is now the twin flame supposed to come in, get awakened as well, and also move towards their life purpose and move towards their direction. So for the most of the cases, you've heard about the twin flame separation. The cases whereby we've had the twin flame separation, whereby one of the twin flames has ended up running. So the separation happens because the connection of the twin flame relationship is very intense, is extremely intense, and one of them cannot handle the other. One of the twin flames is awakened, and they have stepped out of their ego. The other twin flame, on the other hand, they are completely very deep within their ego, and they have got a very huge ego. And most of the cases, even sometimes, it has happened that most of them, they are toxic, and eventually, they could be even narcissists and abusive. And most of the cases, because of that intensive connection, it's like it can appear like a big explosion, whereby one of the twin flames will actually end up running away. They cannot handle the intensity, and most of the cases you've got the runner, then you have got the chaser. Now the twin flame, who is the toxic one, they end up now chasing the runner because they still want that connection to happen, and they end up chasing. So that's why you see you have left your twin flame behind, and all of a sudden, eventually, you've blocked them. Sometimes you've decided to cut them off your social media, and all of a sudden, even sometimes you've blocked each other. But somewhere 2-3 weeks down the road, you're going to see the twin flame now unblocking you, because they are trying to get you back and to step back into that partnership. They are trying to come back into that partnership. What I'm trying to say in this video, people, is that the narcissist, they have actually mastered this art of the twin flame connection. Most of the cases of the narcissists, many of them, what they will do after your awakening, those narcissists, they are going to come in as your twin flames. So the narcissists, they will step in and they will start to mirror you. They will mirror everything back to you. So most of the cases, it will look as if you're looking yourself in the mirror. They are going to mirror each and every small detail, each and everything you're doing. And in this video, I want to make it very clear, people. If you ever see a situation whereby you have met somebody, they have started originally specifically talking about they are your twin flames. They have started making you believe they are your twin flames. You have got actually to take a closer look, people, because it is most likely you're dealing with these narcissistic demons. Those demons have come into your life to abuse and manipulate you, and most of the cases they are standing in front of you as your twin flames, but these are narcissists in disguise. If you have noticed a specific pattern, you have met somebody, and eventually that person is actually putting themselves in that position of being your twin flames. Most of the cases, people, these are narcissists in disguise. They are not even close to your twin flames. These people, they are just mirroring you because they believe you don't have the knowledge you need. So they are coming in to mirror you, everything back to you. And eventually, most of the cases, people, they have ended up with narcissists, sometimes even believing they have made their twin flames. And end of the day, somewhere down the road, just for them to realize that actually, this was never a twin flame connection. These individuals were simply narcissists in disguise. It is very often and a very common scenario. After awakening, individuals, they have reported cases whereby they have actually, myself, I've had a situation whereby I met my original twin flame. But because of that intensity, the intensity of the connection I've explained, because one of the twin flames is not awakened. They are not yet spiritually awakened. So they are still asleep. And the only reason why I had to meet that twin flame was actually, we had to get that spark of the awakening together. So they are coming in to get the spark of the awakening so that they can also get awakened and step into their divine purpose. So me realizing that the twin flame usually was a very toxic individual, I had to step out of that partnership because I never saw anything going on. I could never see where we're heading in that direction, I could never see that we were heading in the right direction. So I had to step out of that connection. But I can guarantee you, people, me stepping out awakened the second twin flame. But that's not what I'm talking about in this video. The one I'm talking about is the narcissist who is going to come into the relationship as a twin flame. They are going to step into that relationship trying to mirror everything back to you and pretend in front of you that they're your twin flame. So you should have a double check and closer look at those individuals. Most of the cases, the narcissist, the best thing they can do, that is their playbook, that is their playground. Mirroring back empaths is the narcissist playground. That's the what they do best. So most of the cases, it is going to be almost too good to be true. In 1 or 2 or 3 days, you are going to almost believe you've met your twin flame, because the narcissist, they are very good at mirroring back at people. And most of the cases, many individuals are falling in that trap. And actually believed that they have met their twin flames. So, in this video, I just want to prepare you, because on my page, there's a lot of people who's awakening. There's so many people who's awakening, and many people who's starting to get back, to take their power back and step out from narcissistic relationships, abusive relationships. I want to prepare you people. There is going to be a clique of narcissists. Those narcissists, they are going to come in not because they are your twin flames. You are supposed to know who is a twin flame in the first place. And even then, if it's true that you've met your twin flame, it is likely you're going to meet a toxic one. If you have met a twin flame, somebody who is saying they're your twin flame, number one, they could be narcissists, the real narcissists in disguise. Number two, they could be your actual twin flames. But like I said, either way it goes, one of the twin flames has got to be very deeply toxic. Because they are not fully awakened, they are still into their ego, they are still deep within their ego, so they are not awakened, they are not spiritually awake. And the only thing they are coming in to tap into the awakening. You are the one actually who is responsible for waking up your twin flame. And at the end of the day, the separation has got to happen so that now you can go and continue working on yourself and your journey. And your twin flame also supposed to carry on and go on working on their journey, so that you can all be able to fulfill your purpose, the reasons why you exist, and the reasons why you exist and the reason why you're here. Carry out your divine purpose as twins. The second twin flame who is going to appear as a twin flame, that is going to be the narcissist. It is very likely very likely that narcissist is going to come in and identify themselves as your twins. They will try to cook the way you do. They will try to mirror the way you dress. They will try to mirror the way you eat. They try to mirror the way you sleep. They try to mirror the way you put your makeup. They will try to mirror your clothes. Each and everything about you, they are actually going to stand in. It is going to be scary in most of the cases. When you see these narcissists who are actually mirroring, who are playing the twin flame game, it is going to be almost too good to be true, because you are going to see each and everything you're doing. You are going to almost think you have just met your double. The narcissist people, there is narcissists who have mastered the game of mirroring the twin flame connection, and they do it perfectly well. If you don't have the eyes of discernment and the spirit of discernment, it is going to be almost impossible for you to see these individuals for who they are. It is going to be possible. Before you know it, you're going to be very deep within the trauma bond. And before you know it, you're going to be swimming and diving deep into a very toxic long-term relationship. So you're supposed to have the spirit of discernment. That is why in my videos I've always said, heal is very important. Heal. Do not rush into any relationship. Don't rush. There's no reason to rush. You have got all the time, people. You are supposed to make sure that you try very hard, very much, put in the work to heal. It is only by healing that you're going to be able to attract your vibrational match. By healing, you attract your vibrational match. The person who is meant and supposed to be in your life. The person meant for you, not these fake twin flames and those narcissists in disguise who come in as twin flames. And even then, you're going to meet your twin flame. But at the same time, that twin flame is also going to be a toxic individual. They may not necessarily be narcissists. They may not be narcissists in this case. They could have had some things they're dealing with, trauma they're dealing with, or whatever. And the only thing they need is to get in touch with you and get their awakening. Because eventually when they get in touch with you, they are going to get awakened in some way. You are the only person, if you have awakened, you are the only person capable of awakening your twin flame. If those twin flames are not indeed narcissists, if they get into contact with you, you are the only person who is capable of awakening those twin flames. Nobody else is going to awaken their twin flames. You are the only person who is going to awaken them. And eventually, after the separation, you are going to see a very big change in those people if you have met them. But again, That is going to be a different subject because the twin flame subject is a very long one. So we're going to talk about that one later. The soulmate and the twin flames, we're going to get into that later. But in this video, I just want to open your eyes and to make you aware that there's narcissists who are also, there's those twin flames who are also narcissists in disguise. So you're supposed to have that spirit of discernment. That is why healing is very, very crucial and very important. Healing gives you the spirit of discernment. You can never be able to, you can never, ever be fooled again. When you've met those individuals, you can decipher them straight away for who they are. You can see them for who they are straight away. You don't have to wait a couple of times before you actually know who they are. It is going to be very easy for you to figure these individuals out, who they are. And you'll be able also to protect yourself. So don't fall for the twin flame game. 1, 2, 3 days after meeting those individuals, they are going to become your twin flames. They are going to mirror you, each and everything back to you. Your sleeping habits, the way you pretend, your personality, your character, your dressing, your eating, each and everything about you, they are going to mirror everything back to you. And it is going to look like too good to be true. That is where the game becomes very tricky, because those are people, those are narcissists in disguise. They have never been at any point your twin flames. Your real twin flames. The twin flames are going to also come in at some point. But you should be able to decipher between a narcissist and somebody who just have some kind of karmic situations going on, some kind of toxic situations going on in their patterns. So when the twin flame comes in, they are coming in not because they are coming in to have a relationship with you. Most of the twin flames relationships, they never mature into full-blown relationships. Most of the cases, twin flames are just coming in to get their awakening from you. And at the end of the day, the separation is supposed to happen whereby the both of you now will go separate ways and you can all go out and start working on your divine journeys and your divine purpose. But that connection is not an intimate connection. The twin flame connection is usually not an intimate connection. It is very few cases. And the only cases whereby a twin flame connection can end up into an intimate connection, that is only when both of the twin flames, they have done the work. So you have separated, then both of you have gone separate ways. You have all put in the work to really work on yourself. And some cases, there are some of them who have succeeded successfully, come back into a twin flame reunion, which is also going to be a different subject. So people, in this video, I can't make it any longer than this. Let me have your comments in the section below. If you have met a fake twin flame, if you have met a twin flame who has happened to be toxic, if you have met a twin flame who is a narcissist in disguise, I want to know from you guys in the comment section below. Other than that, guys, much love and blessings. As always, Desmo signing out. Love you all.